development and the foundations of development are actually have to start already in crisis and in humanitarian type of situation. You know, we don't want to do humanitarian work for too long, right? Only as long as it's necessary, saving lives, getting people back in business. But after that, development takes over, right? So as UNDP, we are convinced that we need to be there early on. That's why you find very sizable UNDP programs in Yemen, in Lebanon, in what we call typically humanitarian places. You'll find UNDP doing early recovery or nexus type of work, as we say. Try to contribute to the humanitarian phase lasting as short as needed, right? So that a country can start thinking about itself, putting itself back together rather than be dependent on import of food, or distribution of water and all those things. However good they are, we don't want that to last forever, right? One signature program of ours is Cash for Work, for example. I mean, rather than giving stuff to people, which again, I love it because we are in business to help people, right? So when they need water, we need to give them water. Yeah. But the moment it is possible, we prefer to give them some job, right? Even if it's to clean a street or to cook something or to make something so that they can have an income and have their own dignity back. Because holding up your hand for food and oil and water is not dignified for people, right? It's not a life. So that is what UNDP wants to work on from the very beginning, but all the way into the development phase. Well, everybody in principle can apply. I mean, but of course, in those areas where UNDP is active. I understand that most of your Kalu Institute clients and students are humanitarians. I mean, what I'm picturing, of course, is not pure humanitarian work, right? We do not distribute water. We do not do a lot of logistics. We don't fly in airplanes full of food. There, that's humanitarian, right? But livelihood experts, early rule of law, supporting traditional systems of coping of people, a lot of capacities that are very close to humanitarian, but not quite. But I'm sure among your students, there are a ton of people that could actually apply. So you can actually go to a website of ours. I mean, the best way to put it, you go to Twitter, Express Roster, yes. Our Twitter account. There you find a hyperlink to the place where you can apply. And when you apply, you actually see the whole list of capabilities that we're looking for. You tick the ones that you are good at, and then you hang on your CV, and then you will be vetted by our technical teams. Mm-hmm. And then within a couple of days or weeks, you are on the roster. And from the moment you're on the roster, we also agree with you on your daily rate and those kind of things. Everything is pre-agreed so that by the time we need you, we call you. You say, I'm available, not available. We do our quick TOR and you're ready to go. So the roster is a way for us to be much quicker. We don't have to advertise again. We don't have to make a long selection, short list and long list. We don't do interviews at that moment in time because we already get that done when you're enrolling on the roster.